It's race day in Budapest as we get ready for another round of Formula One action. We're not expecting too many retirements at this circuit. There are plenty of current and former drivers with flawless finish rates here. In particular, Ralf Schumacher, who made it across the line in all 10 of his Hungarian Grand Prix starts. The Hungaroring, it's like Monaco without the boats, although the boats today could come in very handy. 14 corners, 6 to the left and 8 to the right, and some very tricky corners to deal with. These rainy conditions out there aren't going to help either, so it's very likely we'll see a safety car or two during today's race. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Lightning lines up on pole position, and it's Pierre Gasly in P2. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Sainz, Leclerc, Alex Albon, and Verstappen. Richard Vachon, Ocon, Oscar Piastri, and Daniel Ricciardo. Tsunoda, Norris, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Felipe Drugovich, Ans Latifi, Liam Lawson, Fittipaldi, Robert Schwartzman, and Jehan Deruvala, Magnussen, Yuri Vips, Bottas, and Guan Yu Zhou. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway.
After the points finished last race, let's aim. Launch map is good, but we need to learn the gears. So go into each one when you can. We're going to need some work on the brakes, so put some energy into them and warm the tyres as well, please. Okay, incredible parking there, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get good launch as the race starts. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights. Stay clear. Okay, watch your pace. We've been informed the safety car is out. There appears to have been an issue with multiple stopped vehicles on the track. I've got information on Lawson. Right, they've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. Approaching the safety car, you're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. Looks like we're running on a dry track soon. Back to dry shortly. Okay, the safety car's coming in this lap. We'll be pacing the field in sector 3. Make sure to respect the delta until the safety car's into the pit lane. Okay, some information on Gasly. They've got an issue with their car, they're going to be slow. not a perfect situation, but I don't think we've got cause to move on to a different tyre yet. So we're leading our teammate by 7.2 seconds. Okay, the officials have deployed the safety car due to multiple cars being stopped on track. Mind your Delta. I'd come in and change tyres. I'm just not sure we're on the right ones for these conditions anymore. Lando's in the pits. Lando in the pits. You're approaching the safety car. You're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. Strategy available on the MFD. Okay, copy that. Look after these tyres now, and we'll finish the race on this compound. field accelerates, remember there's no overtaking until the timing line. Safety car in this lap. Radar suggests weather's going to hit in around 5 minutes' time, so stay on your toes. Gap to your teammate behind is 1.5 seconds. Perez, we're leading our teammate by 2.8 seconds. That's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left.
Our drivers have all pushed themselves this season, making it one of the most compelling years of racing in history. There can only be one champion, however, and here they are now, our new Formula One World Drivers' Champion. Not just victory today, then, but the championship as well. What a spectacular season they've had. Congratulations to the whole team. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, you know what they say, to finish first you have to finish. The fact was clear today, with a lot of retirements having a big effect on the outcome of the race. As a driver, you tend to keep reliability concerns at the back of your mind and just focus on what's in front of you. But for teams, races like this can be very stressful.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way onto the podium now. let's focus on the driver of the day. Natalie Pinkham, come on, who do you pick?
Jehan Daruvala gets my vote today.
The Constructors' Championship may be a foregone conclusion at the moment, but regardless, let's look at the standings. With that result, the sport's newest team can no longer be touched at the top of the table. What an incredible journey this has been for a team many had written off a short time ago. They are the Formula One World Champions. There was also a strong showing from the Mercedes team today as they make their way up the standings. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport action. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
Our running costs are significantly less than the income we're pulling in. I suggest we start looking for opportunities to spend that profit margin.